Welcome back to the Road Show this morning in the buzz. I think we're all buzzing from the sugar. With the NCAA tournament field all set and ready to roll, it's time to turn our attention to this right here. Wendy, if you'll get a shot of that, to picking the brackets. But first, if you're like Courtney and me, you'll need to know how to fill one out. So we decided to utilize our resident expert, Patrick Little, to explain the nuances of bracketology, especially a few of us ladies, what is the obsession here? Take a look.
Everyone has a pool. For years, you know, my friends and I have always filled out our brackets, and we bet peanuts, a lot of trash talking.
All right. There is a lot of trash talking, especially in the newsroom. I've heard it. Oh, who are you picking?
I'm going to win.
But actually, I did hear an interesting fact that filling out the brackets and getting it all correct is the chances of doing that are equivalent to winning a multi-million dollar lottery two weekends in a row. So what's the point?
Well,
I think that the best part, I'm just going to interrupt because clearly, why would I not talk over the sports director? The upsets, that's where I'm like, what do you mean a number, 11th seed is going to beat a 2 seed? Can that happen, Pat?
Eventually.
Well, but an underdog.
But
no, but an underdog. And that is fun. The fun part of it, especially like even in the Olympics when you see like the men's figure skating team from Sweden, just,
those are even. Yeah,
right,
I know what you're talking about.
But when you're rooting for an underdog and they come out on top.
Yeah. It's been sitting there for 25 years.
All right, so tell me about that. All I know is that Kentucky's taking it. That's what Ernie told
us. Sorry, ladies. Let me explain this to you.
Okay, go for it.
All right, the reason why we do these things are purely for entertainment purposes only.
Okay. Right?
I mean, there's no financial ramifications involved, at least not
because
here.
Because it's not legal, technically.
No, it's not.
So we're talking about the novelty of it. Sure.
Right. Just speaking from prior experience, when you fill out the office pool here at this TV station, the winner...
Were we to have one, hypothetically?
Right.
Go ahead.
Hypothetically speaking. But we actually do. But it's not... I'm straying away from the financial gains here. You actually get this park closest to the building. You know that in the Employee of the Month parking spot?
Oh, Jay lets you do that. Our general manager lets you park. Hold on. Let me fill one of these out.
Actually, her bracket.
Yeah, seriously.
I'm not sure if Jay lets us do that. I actually just made that up.
Okay. Right.
On live TV. So I'm hoping that we implement that change.
That for okay
that's my wife, by the way, filling out that pool.
Who's she taking as the winner?
I don't know.
Some inside help from you, I'm sure.
But, so I've won the parking spot two out of the last 3 years, but I was supposed to. I'm the sports guy, and that's my thing. But, a lot of people pick these. If you have the office pool for the parking spot, a lot of people pick they give them to their, spouses, the men give them to their wives or their daughters or their dogs or whatever, and people pick the teams based on the mascot or the school color or the nickname, and then they end up winning the darn thing.
Yeah, isn't that funny?
I mean, so it tells you that, I may give you, my friend's up in, a lawyer up in Boston calls me, I guarantee he calls me, we talk like twice a year.
Yeah.
And this is one of the days.
Okay.
Yo, I need you to help me with my pool. And I'm like, all right, but I mean, really, you could pick by the higher seed, but I mean, even if you go by mascots or colors of teams, you could still
win. So there's no science to it.
There's some science to it when you get later. I think, the upsets in the beginning of the first, round of games, it's kind of
crazy,
tough.
Right?
Yeah. You go 50-50.
I did one with all of my college girlfriends. Now, we all went to the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, who won the national championship last year. So we did this pool last year, and the winner got to choose where we all went on this big birthday vacation.
That's a good
But the problem is we all picked North Carolina.
Ah.
So there were no real winners.
Gotcha.
This year, North Carolina's in it, and my husband, I'm filling it out. I said, what should I do? What should I do? And he said, you got to have Duke going the farthest of anybody. Because rivals, so none of the rest of the girls are going to go for Duke.
Oh,
so if you go
right.
for Duke, you could end up with the big win.
Yeah, that's a good point.
I couldn't go with them going that far.
No.
I get a couple around. They're like, I'm done with Duke.
And Ben just wanted me to say that he chooses the.
The shortest skirts on the cheerleaders.
Well, right. The school with the largest cheerleading crew.
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
He picks in their brackets. So he's done research through media guides of all the schools involved.
Yeah.
So
excellent.
Ben's bracket's very interesting.
A lot of interpersonal research. Yeah. Ben's really into that. You said some people handed it off to their dogs. I wouldn't be surprised if Courtney Caligiuri gave it to Riley. Because not only is it his second birthday,
dog
Riley, but, he's a snappy dresser. He could probably figure this out.
Smart dog.
He does. He has a tuxedo hanging in the closet. Not too shabby. Hey, Patrick, I wanted to tell you, our boss is live blogging with us. He has a message for you. I want to read it really quick before we get to the comments. He says, tell Little he can win the right to wash the news trucks. No parking spot for him. I love it. I love that he's watching. It's great. Very, very good.
At least he didn't just fire me on the spot.
No.
I'll clean the car.
You've got the other job there. So we've got a couple of comments on here, and they're all kind of in my corner here. They're not really into basketball, but happy to see it back in Providence. And Jean's going to keep quiet because she knows nothing about it. And Erin wishes them all good luck because she doesn't follow it. But we do have followers on Facebook, so I will get to that in just 1 second. But if you are doing the NCAA bracket, here's our poll on the homepage. How do you pick your teams for the NCAA bracket? A, based on the team's stats. B, by the mascot and or colors of the team. C, my favorite teams regardless of their stats. Or D, other. So you can weigh in there, those that are familiar. Or you can comment with our friends on Facebook right now. We've got about 8 or 10. This has been the trend all this week. And Newland Bonsu says she did it last year and it was too much work. And Brian Bowden says, I pick favorites 1, 2, 3, and 4 seeds. Then I flip a coin for the rest of the tournament. So he also says he copied President Obama's bracket sheet, too. I guess he found that online. So we'll see how that worked out for him. But I'll be back in about 30 minutes with those poll results for you guys. But now we're going to head back to the kitchen to see how the fish in a bag is doing. Patrick.